Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's see some problems that involve converting condensed structural formulas into Lewis dot structures. Check the description of this video to find links to the problems in this video as well as a solution set. There will be links during the video that will connect you to other relevant tutorial videos. Before starting the problems, let's review a few ideas. First, condensed structural formulas are read from the left to the right. Second, when we draw our Lewis dot structures, we will draw each bond as a line and lone pairs as two dots. Third, for the problems in this video, all second row atoms will have full octets and no formal charges. Let's get into the problems. Here are our first three questions. Our first molecule is water. So when reading condensed structural formulas, we want to start with our leftmost larger atom. That means not hydrogen, but we'll start with the oxygen. So the oxygen is attached to two hydrogens. This oxygen needs a full octet. Right now we only show two bonds to it, two lines. It needs eight total electrons. So to get eight electrons, we need two lone pairs. That gives it a full octet. The next question. So this is methanol. Now we don't have to get far into the molecule before we encounter our first larger atom, this carbon. So we have a carbon. That carbon is attached to three hydrogens. Two, three. Now the carbon is also attached to the next atom in the line, oxygen. That oxygen has a hydrogen on it. And again, oxygen doesn't have a full octet. It only has two lines to it. That's four electrons. We need two more lone pairs to give it a full octet. Carbon is fine. It has four bonds, so it already has a full octet. Our last molecule on this slide is kind of a strange molecule. It's called hydroxylamine. Again, we immediately hit a second row element. So there's our nitrogen. It is attached to two hydrogens. This nitrogen is also attached to the next atom in the line, oxygen. That oxygen has a hydrogen. Now we need to think about our octets. Nitrogen right now has three bonds. That's only six electrons. It needs another lone pair to complete its octet. Oxygen has only four electrons showing in its two bonds. It needs two more lone pairs to get a complete octet. So those are the first three questions. Okay, let's look at our next three questions. We have this molecule in the upper left. So we look at this molecule, there's a hydrogen. We don't start with a hydrogen, but here's an oxygen, a second row element. So there's our oxygen, and it will be attached to that hydrogen on the left. Now this oxygen is attached to the carbon. This carbon in turn has two hydrogens. One, two. This carbon now is going to connect down the line as we continue to the right to the last carbon. And the last carbon has three hydrogens on it. One, two, three. Our last carbon, as you can see, already has four bonds, so it has a full octet. This carbon has four bonds, so it has a full octet, but this oxygen has two bonds. Now, oxygen normally forms two bonds, but that's only four valence electrons. We need four more valence electrons, and we will get those through two lone pairs. Okay, now how about this molecule in the middle? It's a little bit different. We start with our carbon, and this carbon has two bonds to hydrogen, and then this carbon is also going to be bonded to the oxygen. Now this oxygen is a little different because it doesn't have an OH. Oxygen normally makes two bonds. As it turns out, our carbon is also missing a bond. It only has three bonds. So we are going to have a double bond between the carbon and the oxygen. Now oxygen now has the two bonds that we often see, but it still doesn't have a full octet. So we need to have two lone pairs to give it a complete octet. That one is a little more difficult. Double bonds aren't always shown in condensed structural formulas, and so sometimes we have to infer where there's the double bond. We'll see this again in this next question. We start with our carbon on the far left, It has three hydrogens. This carbon, in turn, is attached to the next carbon. Now, this oxygen in the parentheses means that when you use parentheses, these are branch points in your molecule. So this branch, this oxygen branch, continues until we end the parentheses. And at that point, the rest of the molecule continues, the CH3, off of the carbon that precedes it before the branch point occurred. So this carbon in our molecule now is going to be attached to both the oxygen and the methyl group. So here is our bond coming off to our oxygen, and here is also our bond coming to what is the CH3 group. Let's go ahead and fill in those three hydrogens. Again, we run into this case where here we have this oxygen. This oxygen doesn't have an OH group. So all of this oxygen's bonds are back to this carbon. So oxygen normally makes two bonds, and we're going to see that oxygen make two bonds. Now, when we think about octets, we have four bonds to this carbon, that's no problem. Four bonds to this carbon, that looks good. Four bonds to this carbon, whoops, didn't mean to write that. That looks good. In fact, before we get confused, let's erase that. Okay, good. Now, we have this oxygen. This oxygen doesn't have a full octet. For this oxygen, we need to give it two lone pairs to complete its octet. Here are our next two problems, problems 7 and 8. So for this top molecule, we're going to skip the hydrogen for a second, go straight to the oxygen. Now, once we have the oxygen, let's fill in that hydrogen. The oxygen is, in turn, attached to a carbon. This carbon has a hydrogen. And note that the carbon is also bonded to these next atoms. Now, I say next atoms because we have a branching that's going on. That's what the parentheses tell us. And there are going to be two of these branched groups. So off of our carbon, we're going to have one carbon, which is a CH3, and a bond to another carbon, which is a CH3. Now, as we look at this structure, all of our atoms have full octets, four bonds to that carbon, four bonds to that carbon, and alas, four bonds to that carbon, but our poor oxygen only has two bonds. We need it to get four more electrons to give a total of eight so we can satisfy the octet rule. Now, our bottom structure. We immediately start with a carbon with three hydrogens. This carbon is in turn going to be attached to the next carbon, and that has an H on it. Now we're going to have another branch. So inside this branch, there is an OH. So this carbon is attached to that oxygen. It's also going to be continuing the chain on that CH3. So we'll draw the oxygen going down for no particular reason. We draw it anywhere we want. And that oxygen has an H. We'll now continue with this last CH3 group. There's our carbon. And it has three bonds to hydrogens. Now, every atom has a full octet, four bonds, all the carbons, except for oxygen. It only has two bonds, so it will need to have two lone pairs to get a full octet. Okay, for our last problems, we have molecules that are a little bit bigger. So, in this first question, problem number 9, we start with a carbon, but notice this carbon is within parentheses, so there are going to be two of these CH3 groups. And what are they connected to? They're both going to be connected to this carbon. So let's actually start with that carbon, and we will have coming off of that carbon our two CH3 groups. These are the two CH3s in the parentheses. Squeeze in a hydrogen. There we go. Now, off our carbon, we have a hydrogen, so let's show that hydrogen. Now, this carbon is also attached to a nitrogen. That nitrogen has a hydrogen, and then the nitrogen, in turn, is attached to our end CH3. If we look at our carbons, they all have four bonds, so they all have full octets. Only the nitrogen has three bonds, so it needs more electrons to satisfy its octet. And the lone pair will fulfill that nitrogen's octet. Okay, so let's do Question number 10, we'll draw this kind of at the bottom. We start with a carbon that has a CH3. That carbon is in turn attached to another carbon with an H. Now this, we're going to encounter parentheses. So this is a branch point. This carbon is connected to the branch. It's also connected to this carbon as the main chain continues. So let's work on this branch right here. Again, this is going to be a little bit cramped. There's our first carbon, which has two hydrogens. And there is, as in turn, attached to that CH3. One, two, let's squeeze it up here, three. Now we're going to continue the main chain. So our carbon is now, let's bring in this CH2 group. So there is that carbon with two hydrogens, and this is a horrific structure. So now we have finally our NH2. So there's our nitrogen with two hydrogens. All of our carbons have four bonds. Some of them are not very pretty. This carbon does have four bonds. That satisfies our octet rules, or the octet rule. This nitrogen only has three bonds. It needs two more electrons to fill out its valence, and so it has a lone pair. So those are some quick examples of solving, converting condensed structural formulas into Lewis dot structures. I hope you have found this video useful. Please subscribe, give a like, or leave a question or comment. Thank you for watching. Remember that links to these problem sets are in the description.